There's like the lie where you leave key information out.
I can't believe you. I have done nothing to deserve this kind of mistrust.
All right, now listen up, you limey bum sniffers.
Hey, it's me.
Earn cash, travel, meet new people.
Anybody been on the airplane? You ever went in that bathroom on the airplane?
Crimson on the bingham with a gamgum.
I feel back to normal. In fact, I probably feel better than I did before.
Creatures on the upper with the tramstone!
Yeah, you're in good company.
You know, like I've said 1,000 times, we're just different places in our lives.
See Roger the Boogly.
Hi, everybody, and welcome to NSS. This is the Reynolds Report. A lot of us are getting hit by a wicked cold front, which is why this caught our eye. The Washington Post just did a story on whether or not warming up your car before you drive actually does anything. And the answer is no, or at least it doesn't do anything beneficial for the car itself. It used to be necessary back when cars had carburetors, which needed the engine to warm up before they'd work right. But by the 1990s, almost all cars had electronic fuel injectors, which automatically compensate for the temperature. So, as long as you're not in a 30-year-old car, you probably don't need to let it warm up. The only practical reason to do it is so the inside of the car gets warm, or so you can crank the defrost, which is probably why most people do it. But if you're running late for work, there's no need to sit there waiting and worrying if the engine is ready. You could also end up wasting a decent amount of gas. A 2009 survey found that when it's cold out, the average person lets their car warm up for about 5 minutes. And a test showed that when it's right around 0 degrees, letting your car idle for just 5 minutes can increase your total fuel consumption by 7 to 14%. Hey, Game of Thrones fans, if you think the only thing that could make Game of Thrones better is a bigger screen, you're in luck. Yeah, it's headed to the biggest one of all. Later this month, the HBO show will become the first TV series ever to appear on IMAX screens, with 150 IMAX theaters airing the last 2 episodes of the 4th season. The theaters will also show an exclusive trailer for the upcoming 5th season, which debuts in April. The limited IMAX showing will run from January 23rd to 29th. The episodes will be digitally remastered for IMAX. Charlie Sheen wildly tore into Kim Kardashian on Twitter after hearing that she ignored a 6-year-old girl who was asking for an autograph. The story turned out to be untrue, but that didn't stop Chaz. He mocked Kim's gross and jiggly butt and said she had 0 gratitude, 0 awareness, 0 talent, and was a, quote, pox on the face of entertainment. He ended with this shot, and this one's my favorite, quote, "My apologies to your hubby. Great guy, I'm sure. I hope his vision returns one day." He later took it all back, apologized to Kim, and reminded everybody that he's an idiot. Hey, speaking of Kim Kardashian, she recently said she's obsessed with Kanye West. "Join the club," replied Kanye West. Gwyneth Paltrow says she doesn't know why women can be so mean to each other. "Based on my experience, it's because they know I only have so many 20s when I hit the strip club." A new study says that frequent moviegoers are desensitized to violence. "Hey, I see tons of movies and I'm fine. In fact, I think whoever did this study should be executed." AC/DC and Steely Dan are among the headliners for the first night of Coachella, or as they're calling it this year, Parents Night. A new book claims that Amelia Earhart and her husband had an open marriage, which is where the phrase "fly the friendly skies" actually comes from. The Hubble telescope has taken a picture of a phenomenon known as the Pillars of Creation, but no one under 25 cares because it wasn't a selfie posted on Instagram. A record number of people participated in an anti-Islam rally in Germany. Well, I wouldn't worry about that too much. I mean, it's not like a bunch of Germans have ever gotten swept up in a fanatical wave of religious intolerance and done anything crazy. The average person passes gas 10 times every 24 hours. Finally, an area where I'm considered way above average. A Florida man was arrested after allegedly slapping the employees of his reptile shop with a bearded dragon lizard. It's especially troubling since bearded dragon lizard is his nickname for his junk. Bill Gates drank a glass of water from a machine that converts raw sewage sludge into drinkable water. Gates hopes the machine can also convert other types of crap, like Zune and every edition of Internet Explorer. An Audi A7 Sportback drove itself from Silicon Valley to Las Vegas, where it promptly lost a bundle at roulette and was forced to hitchhike home. And in America, the new members of Congress have taken over. It hasn't even been a week, and already they've tossed a sofa into the swimming pool and peed off the balcony. Thanks, everybody. We have a new episode of The Reynolds Report every weekday. Be sure to check out The Being Frank Show starring Frank D'Angelo, live Tuesdays and Thursdays at 3 p.m. Eastern here on NSS.